Kind of going by the numbers, this could set us up for that Nautilus first pick.
Yeah.
And it has kind of defined who's been able to win so far.
I think Misfits stick with the Elise ban here. If they do adjust it, maybe take away that Kalista, deal with anything that G2 had to offer. While it wasn't successful, you could see certainly what G2 were trying to set up with a slight adaptation on their playstyle, adding that big protection around the AD carry.
Yeah, gonna change it up now. All right, so Talon banned out in the first rotation allows Trick to potentially play Elise. He's only played it once this split, so it's not exactly, you know, the number one champion I think of when it comes to Trick. But as you mentioned, Stress, Nautilus was first pick. All right, we're going to see some changes. So Malzahar is available. Yeah. Elise is available. What do Misfits want to first pick?
I think Malzahar, yeah. It has to be. Ignar has looked so good on this champion. Fighting over vision, catching people out, everything has worked well. And this is the beginning of a very active Misfits lineup, but there is that lane counter available.
Yeah, we'll find out if Mithy decides to run that Lulu again with Sven's Kalista. But, you know, if you think back 2 weeks ago when Misfits played the Unicorns of Love, Ignar was able to roam around so freely and so comfortably behind Unicorns, the flanking Malzahar. One was the deadliest, and G2, they're gonna pull a little bit of a fast one on us.
That's a statement. Picking Caitlyn this early on, that says we're pushing the lanes, we're taking control, and we are going to bully you around in this bot lane already. So, Misfits now, a little bit of necessary change up in the draft with this Caitlyn pick. Will mean Misfits are gonna need to take an AD carry here, or they will have a lot of the matchups like the Ashe banned away, so that's likely what Misfits will end up picking. And G2 signaling they're going later on into the game with both first picks in this rotation. Haven't seen G2 draft like this very often.
No, very different, but it is a new patch, Stress.
It is.
It is also game three in a series. You need to adapt to how things change out. With AD carry and mid laner already locked in, both of whom are actually relatively safe in lane, right? 90 caliber nets, you've got some traps, you've got some options available to you.
Kakao's trolling a little bit. You don't want to play Kalista into Caitlyn.
Well,
if you're Hansami, you do. Okay. Typically not a matchup that Kalista can ever punish.
And why is that? Why don't you like this?
It's purely range in lane. Kalista, very short range champion. Caitlyn, the longest base range AD carry in the game. So you very quickly punish now in Misfits. Yes, they've got the Malzahar alongside it when they've got good trading potential, but G2 can just keep them at arm's length. Kalista won't even out-push this Caitlyn.
All right, we'll find out how well Hansama can deal with the pressure for Lee Sin. Correction, Kakao, the gloves are off. He's gone back to arguably his best champion this split. Big playmaker. And obviously two champions who he wants to try and flank and kick into the Misfits squad.
And this puts presence now against Trick. They have to go Lulu here to deal with that Malzahar and give them a pushing option. Caitlyn Lulu, one of the fastest pushing lanes that there is, despite multiple nerfs to Lulu and her push potential. G2 locking in a very, very heavy push-focused bot lane. Now, this does shrink the pool for Trick because there should be a couple of jungle bans coming out from Misfits. This Lee Sin could take away the Graves here. The Kha'Zix, another matchup that we've seen do fairly well into Lee Sin.
Or do they go full protect the Caitlyn and pick Ivern on the side of Trick?
I don't think so. I really don't think so. Against Kakao on Lee Sin, they're going to take away a disengaged champion that we haven't seen Trick play, but we've seen other people bringing back into the jungle. That Gragas, take it away. Don't allow them to push back the Misfits when they try and engage.
Also, a top lane champion to remove from the pool as well.
Very true.
As you can see, Nautilus was banned earlier by G2 with Ahri off the table for Power of Evil. He's going to look back to something else. What else would you run? Syndra is removed from the pool. Ryze is still available, but short range into an Orion and a Caitlyn, maybe not the best. What other options does PoE have? Do you think that he can fall back on?
I mean, PoE, as you said, Syndra is not available. Might go for the Vlad that he hovered in the previous game and has seen a rise in priority. G2 will likely open with their jungle pick here. They will likely pick up something like a Graves or a Kha'Zix, whatever is left available that Misfits don't ban away, because they need to save their top lane matchup for Expect to be able to have a safe match later. You don't want to let Alfari get his hands on any kind of counter matchup. So that's likely to be the pacing here as we enter into phase two of the picks.
All right, we see fairly mixed damage so far. A lot of AD on the side of Misfits. Ooh. And blind
they go Nah here. You go Nah here. Straight away, Alfari will take the Nah. This jungle matchup is not important enough for G2 unless they're saving something. Like, there's not many other champions that Trick plays that you would want to hold and show your early lane presence. Because if G2 didn't pick Renekton here, Misfits would likely take it. And then G2 would answer with Gnar, which is focused on later into the game. That would give Misfits the advantage in a lot of respects around the top half of the map, but I don't think G2 needed to do this.
All right, let's see what it works with, because if Trick gets a jungle, jungler that works in his favor, maybe that'll work. But Stress, it'll have to be a big departure from the two previous games, because both Trick and Kakao have not spent a huge amount of time with their laners in the early game. In game number one of this series, it was actually some of their lowest performances in terms of jungle proximity that we've seen all split long. Completely forgot about the Victor, because he's easy to forget.
Yep.
Not the most exciting of champions.
We see a lot of Victor out of teams like SKT play very reactive style and punish heavily. If you make a mistake against the Victor, suddenly you basically lose so much of the map. However, Misfits have some active ingredients to this composition. You've got the Gnar for side lane control, the Lee Sin to go aggressive. You've got an aggressive facing bot lane as well. So this isn't all about reacting for Misfits, whereas G2, hey, Renekton, Elise. This is one way of punishing Gnar.
One way of punishing any lane, in fact. Let's see if Expect and Trick can make it happen. 30 seconds left on the clock. Misfits have got a fairly well-rounded team comp here. Like conditional engage, right? You're looking for a flank from Alfari or Kakao, or a flash ulti from Ignar. Or you know what? How about a Fate's Call? Let Kalista lob the Malzahar into you and then ulti. But on the side of G2, it feels like it's very heavily pick-focused. You know, they don't have a traditional front line with that Renekton.
Yeah, a lot of it will be focused on Renekton getting into that back line with that shockwave on him. Kalista, although will be shut down by a Ruthless Predator stun if he gets there, can obviously avoid Renekton heavily. Keep in mind, we're going to see, the, as you said, Fate's Call, throwing Ignar in, close the distance, get that suppression down. Maybe you're already dealing enough damage in that fight to have it won in favor of Misfits.
A lot of tension on the line. Here's the team compositions for you. Power of Evil and Hansama playing Victor and Kalista respectively for the first time this split. Sven playing Caitlyn as well for the first time this split. And see how well they perform on patch 7.5. Earlier today, 62% of you guys were in favor of Misfits with that hashtag vote. We'll check in during this game if that has changed. Hashtag MSFWin or hashtag G2Win.
A lot of first times in this game by the sounds of it, but will it be the first time G2 have lost a series in over a year?
393 days to be precise. Ladies and gentlemen here in Berlin, thank you for your noise. We load up into game three as Misfits take on G2. Before we get to the Nexus and before we talk about the implications of who's going to win or lose, let's see whether the napping Misfits shows up, or let's see whether or not game two Misfits shows up. The proactive, not the passive play.
It's Kakao on Lee Sin. If he's passive in this game, I don't know what to tell you, because that's not how you play Lee Sin effectively. I really enjoy watching Kakao on Lee Sin. 31, 8, and 65 is his total stat line in his seven games as Lee Sin coming into this series. So he has made an impact and really, really punished people when he's found his way into the enemy jungle. And that's what I want to see. That's what I want to see from Kakao. They just have to weather the early game storm of Elise ganking for Renekton.
Well, let's see if Kakao can counter gank. Let's see if he can read Trick and respond to some of that pressure. That's what we're going to be judging, as Kakao's going to get a very heavy start, heavy help here, rather, from Ignar. He's going to move in with that Void Swarm and Perks and Power of Evil are going to start trading. And you know, Power of Evil, he was down 50 or 60 CS in that previous game, but he still landed what felt like countless charms. And it was that flank over the Raptor wall in the late game that actually ended up sealing the deal in favor of Misfits.
It did. On the other side of the rift, Perks, I think, taking this Orianna, looking maybe for a bit of redemption on the last game where some shockwaves went awry. We saw the same come from Febivan in the H2K series. So this big, influential playmaker ultimate.
Yeah.
If it doesn't quite connect, it can have a massive effect in a negative way on your team fighting.
It can cost the game, and that's exactly what it did. That's why we're here in game number three. The top lane stream is still running. It is Renekton versus Gnar. This will be very exciting with, of course, Deficio, Soaz, and Odawame.
It's going to be a good one. You've got Gnar against Renekton, where Renekton's going to have the early game presence here. And then Gnar will take over in the side lane later on.
I was promised that Soaz would be doing some play-by-play casting. I cannot confirm or verify if that has happened, but definitely ask him to make sure that happens.
So in case you're wondering whether Misfits would look to try and stop Trick heading top, that's a Rift Scuttler and two wards on the top half of the map in the river. And you can see Alfari playing with a lot of respect. There's no path for Trick to head top, and that's why he's looking on the bottom side of the map. Very unorthodox. It's so telegraphed that Elise heads for Renekton. They're actually going to the opposite side and trying to at least steal jungle away.
Okay, let's see whether or not Trick is feeling very confident. In the previous game, Trick spent 46 seconds of his time in range of expect in the first 15 minutes of the game. And now we're going to see Kakao moving up. Is this for a gank or counter gank?
It's countering. That's why the wave is pushing at the same time. They don't recognize, but Ignar knows that Elise might be bot.
Well, that gets the exhaust already. Repel up into the air. Sven and Miffy coming to help out. Ooh. A lot of damage onto Trick.
I love the reaction out of Misfits here, though. They know that with Elise not showing top, there's only really one place they can be. Expect obviously knows Kakao is there, that he's placed that ward. Bot lane is where that first threat is still from Trick sitting there.
Yeah, the Cocoon misses, though, so there's no further follow-up. Cocoon into Polymorph, into Caitlyn's Snaptrap. Mm. You get locked in place for what will feel like 10 years. And G2 will just easily be able to combo you down.
I like what Ignar did, though, checking in for that Elise. Knowing he still had that shield on meant he exhausted one of the abilities. Miffy looking desperately to try and get something down in the way of harassing this bot lane. But Misfits, again, giving a lot of presence over. But game two, we saw Kakao invade, and he's doing it again. He spotted out Elise, but is looking for that bot side play.
Great glitter lance from Miffy. It interrupts the back, but this might end up hurting
him. Can he get in?
Here comes Kakao. Sonic wave onto Miffy. Sven gets caught by the Pierce. He's trying to make his way out. Summoner heal gets used. Also looking at it, it's ignite for Miffy. So if anyone from Misfits goes low, Miffy's gonna look to finish off.
And this is because there isn't a lot of defensive capability out of the Misfits bot lane early on. We spoke about how heavily Caitlyn, Lulu will push. Well, they can also harass you very effectively too. Important to note, Alfari used his teleport to get back up to the lane. Expect has just recalled and is walking back to lane. So we may see some kind of play on bot side if G2 managed to get it, but Kakao wants mid lane first. Perks dodges the Q.
All right, Kakao much more present in the early game. Previously giving up first blood on that very risky invade. This time around, two attempted ganks, one attempted counter gank. So if you think about the first 5 minutes of gameplay, Kakao is already showing up that He's trying to help his lanes out.
I wonder whether Misfits will end up making a play topside a little quicker than we've seen out of them before. The thing about Kakao, you're talking about his early playmaking, a lot of it has been to benefit Alfari, actually. 82% of Alfari's kills before that 15-minute mark have involved Kakao.
Yeah.
So Alfari, despite having a good lane matchup a lot of the time, doesn't necessarily get stuff done on his own. But what he does do is create advantages in the lane, in the CS differential, and try and exploit that. Alfari is going to be a very comfortable player on this Gnar the later this game goes. And you can see again, Trick now spotted out on this ward. No plays available top.
Yeah, of course, Kakao helping out early for the expected play. This time around, Alfari making the correct play. Stress, this is the fourth time that Misfits have made it to a game three. In the three previous times it happened, Misfits won twice, lost once. For G2, this is the fifth time they've made it to a game three this season.
And let me guess.
104. Go figure.
That was going to be my guess.
I know. It was an easy one, so I didn't want to let you finish it. But it is very interesting, and it's going to be exciting to see how the game plays out, because Perks is once again building an advantage in the mid lane, nearly solo, plus 12 CS already.
And the expected bot lane advantage is going in G2's favor as well, but Kakao again visiting mid lane, gonna try and catch Perks out, does have that level 6.
Yeah, he does indeed. Shockwave comes backwards onto Kakao. Kakao's looking for the kick.
Good
Cocoon
flash.
Finds no one though. Perks and Trick flashed for that one.
Important flash from Kakao there. Spots Trick, and as soon as he does, gets himself out of danger. You can see Perks is running that heal. We'll give him that movement speed and the health back on top of it. Krepo postulated that perhaps it was in replacement of Ghost earlier, because Ghost now has that ramp up time where his heal kicks in instantly.
And somebody who does kick in instantly is Kakao. This is why we wanted to see Lee Sin. The impact he's having on the early game is already just so... you can feel it.
Mm-hmm.
Gold-wise, he's still even with Trick. There's no sizable difference. And Kakao's going to have a lot of playmaking ability when it comes to pinballing somebody around. And as you mentioned, Perks now, no flash, no heal. He's got no escape if Kakao tries a repeat gank.
Meanwhile, other side of the Rift, Alfari is getting closer to the point where he feels comfortable to stay up against Trick no matter what. Ninja Tabby completes already. It's once he gets past that frozen mallet point, that's when you really can just kite this Renekton for days and expect knows he has to concede this lane later on. Right now, he can maintain at least an even footing and not have to worry too much.
Well, look, game two starts off. We're nearly 10 minutes in. CS advantage for Perks. CS advantage for Sven. First Tower Blood's going to get secured here just because of this Caitlyn Lulu lane. And remember, it was Sven and Miffy that got ganked, okay? Kakao came to their lane. Let's see what Kakao can do in the top lane before we continue with this discussion. And setup is there. Meganar is going to be available for Alfari. He can Gnar expect into the wall.
And this is one of the things I was actually wondering whether Misfits would adapt with. Expect knows he's under threat. But whether Misfits could have brought their bot lane up to topside, a play that we see in losing bot lane situations, and maybe just looked for the tower trade, because now G2 are getting an uncontestable dragon from this. It is a mountain drake, so that will influence this game heavily when it comes to tower pushing, barons, and all of that. But Misfits, behind the play on this one, behind in mid lane, behind in bot lane, it's top that is going to be a big sticking point for them the longer this one goes.
It will, and Expect's going to try stick to Alfari. Wild Growth will help, but a very easy hop to safety means Alfari gets out clean, and now G2, they first ones to pull the trigger on the swap, and they're now applying more pressure.
And Kakao's even been spotted in the jungle here, so any play on mid lane is already gone for Misfits, and bot lane hasn't even got to the tower yet, and it's full health from all that pushing G2 did. G2 get top and bot before Misfits can respond with anything.
And now you're starting to see the age and the experience of the teams, right? G2 responding very well. We're in a game three situation. They are playing the map well. If we look at the gold graph from game number two, the game state remained very even, with G2 being marginally ahead for a long period of time, nearly 2,000 gold. And then all of a sudden, Misfits just turned it on. We will look at that in just a minute, as right now, we're going to take a look at the base race. The tower trades, it's outer for inner.
Ooh,
and Perks survives
Ooh.
The Chaos Storm. It's just, this is identical to game two. Pressure in three separate lanes, action in the mid lane.
Ignar's stepping up though. A new challenger approaches.
All right, Expect in a sidestep.
Flash ult.
Gonna get caught out. There's the Ignar ult. Ignar ult. Hey, I'll combo them together. First blood picked up by Alfari, and Misfits made that look easy.
It works in nomenclature, it works in game, everything. Thrown at that mid lane for Misfits. Now they want to try and push onto this tower, but with Meganar there, not quite as good a tower pusher. Only headbutts it. Doesn't really work too well.
It's eerily similar to game number two. I'm going to try that gold graph again, as it looks like the action has slowed down. Because G2 made the proactive plays. They got the towers. That's what you're looking at here. That's why that gold dip into the negatives for Misfits. But at 25 minutes, Misfits found team fights. They found picks that then opened up the game. And they've got a combination of Gnar and Lee Sin with Alfari and Kakao piloting that can do exactly the same thing again.
And right at the end of that game, that flank that came out from Power of Evil was beautiful, but at this one, it was all about that flank from Ignar. The Ignalt. Got him.
Just really well played. You know, you look at the damage. Ignar takes a couple shots, easily breaks tower. And there was no support for G2.
Right, and that's the thing is G2 was still pushing up in the top side. We're laughing about the play on mid, but G2, 3 towers to 1. Yes. They did take it in a tower. That does reduce Alfari's impact somewhat on this game because now he doesn't have the safety. The thing is, Gnar, the longer this game goes, loves the longer lanes. It means if Expect pushes up. Now, Expect has to travel further down that lane if he ever wants to try and make any kind of presence.
And listen, we really, really need to praise Perks in the laning phase. Again, he has just destroyed Power of Evil. He's up 30 CS at 12 minutes. That is a monumental amount. And look, again, because of the pressure, because of Sven rotating, G2 are almost taking out their fourth tower of the game.
All from this first pick, Caitlyn.
Yeah.
A lot of teams, you'd say that was greedy, that was showing a lot, but not only that, Caitlyn, the Orianna, these two picks have been working very well from G2, and they were the first two picked in the draft. Like, that is difficult to punish from Misfits because they've gone into this Kalista setup, which basically just falls back in the lane against Caitlyn.
Yeah. And of course, Victor early on falls back to Orianna. But now Perks, okay, so game two and game three, great early game, great laning phase. Not the greatest shockwaves.
Right.
This time around as well, slightly more complex to set up those engages. There was a Maokai previously, there was a Rengar previously. Yes, Renekton and Elise want to be in there, but it's not quite as safe an engage with that ball delivery system.
Very true. Very true. It's not quite as safe. Misfits have the feeling of safety right now for themselves. There's 3 control wards blocking any kind of priority from G2 on that Rift Herald, which Misfits give over to Alfari, now his strength. The damage reduction, everything that comes from side lane threat has just been enhanced for Alfari. And once he gets a couple of items, he'll be able to really work his magic on a side lane.
Alfari was already invested in the mid to late game, and this is just going to help him out. That Glimpse of the Void, working towards that Frozen Mallet, looking down the itemization. Hunslammer already completed that Blade of the Rune King. Slightly cheaper itemization path than Sven's Caitlyn. So for G2, it's now maintain this lead and don't put yourself in a risky situation, right? They want Caitlyn to scale. They want Orianna to scale. And obviously, Renekton and Elise are still very terrifying, but you've got to look for the opportunities where they can combo somebody maybe 2-on-1.
Well, maybe there's an opportunity coming up. 50 seconds.
Oh, there's a skill shot that I love to yell. The cocoon! It catches Kakao. The rappel comes out, and Kakao is taken down. Teleport from Expect as well. 30 seconds before Infernal Drake, but G2 are hungry for blood. They pop Ignar's passive, look for Hunslammer. Wild Growth comes up, Hunslammer's down, and Fate's Call gets Ignar to safety.
G2 have full control over bot side. Misfits had control over top, and Kakao was going aggressive, not really understanding he was on a ward at that point. And everybody from G2 reacts. The wards were already behind Kakao and Expect TP's in. Shuts down any kind of contest over that dragon when it spawns. And 5 seconds to go, Sven pushing onto this tower again.
Vision superiority has defined the 3 games in this series. And G2 extend that gold lead. It's up to 4,000 right now. There was a little drop down. Sven at 172 CS at 15 minutes in the previous game. He's slacking so badly this game. Only 144, obviously.
Kakao. Oh, he got it!
He steals it!
Here comes the TP!
I'm making a joke. Kakao jumps in there. All right, Infernal Drake picked up, and Alfari actually cancels that teleport. Very good smite steal from Misfits.
Kakao, just when you think you caught him in the jungle and punished him, he comes over, steals the Infernal Drake, and now Misfits suddenly right back into this. This is such a back and forth series here. You can never count either team out.
No, you can't. But Misfits are playing with a significant deficit. 3.5K. Yes, they have scaling on their side with the Kalista, with the Gnar. Well, let's take a closer look at the Dragon Steel. Just
goes
a great combo.
In. Trick didn't get his smite off, was trying to combo with the bite, but actually went for Q Smite and couldn't quite get it before Kakao jumped in. Had Smite available.
Just outplayed the execute from Kakao, fired first, I suppose.
Yep, at that point, just jumps in, gets it. Now Misfits have that extra teamfight potency, and they're setting up for a mid lane play. Ignar, he's been here before. This time it's control warded already. Sven, if he moves forward, will get flash ulted.
Okay, flash.
He's no QSS.
There's also a Fate's Call available here for Hans Sommer. He can lob his Malzahar in. Perks is the target. Perks already uses the QSS. Flashes away from the Fate's Call. That's a good shockwave. The fight is being set up, but nobody's caught just yet. G2 don't want to run into a victim. That's a bad place to be. And a Mega Gnar.
And this was a little weird out of Misfits. They're actually going to lose mid tower from this if G2 push, because Kakao is not with the rest of the team. So split decision making once again. Oh, Expect wants to go.
Defensive flash. Alfari's the target. Shockwave was used earlier in the fight. Not even needed this time around. Good damage onto Expect. Wild Growth will keep him alive. But look at all of those Ren stacks. Hans Sommer decides not to pull the trigger. Sven is tagged up by the inner turret. And look at the Caitlyn traps.
Yep.
Completely blocking off Misfits' entry. That's two towers secured after Misfits engage.
Kakao was not with the team. Misfits, it looked like initially that play was all set around taking down mid tower. Only two autos, as you'll be able to see the health bar if Expect heads back up. That tower was so low, and Misfits were focusing on it. And then Ignar ults onto Perks. It looks like the team wasn't ready to react to the Malzahar ult play and drags them away before that tower actually falls. And Misfits end up taking two fights back-to-back that just do not favor them, as the team was just split up.
Well, 20 minutes on the horizon. And G2 Esports looking to add an additional 5 or 6 days to that undefeated streak on European soil in the European LCS. As we do have a pause, we'll give you guys an update the moment I hear some details.
Sorry, I'm a bad luck charm.
It may actually be too soon for that joke.
Sorry.
It may actually be too soon for that one, Stress.
Well, it wouldn't be soon enough for Misfits to turn this game around. If they can, come back into this one. We are 18, nearly 19 minutes into this game, and they are still trailing against G2.
They are, and I do have an update. It is a microphone-related issue on Kakao, as you can see on stream right now. So our technicians will be chatting to Kakao shortly and double-checking you can communicate with the team. Extremely important when you're playing a champion like Lee Sin. And I'm taking a look really quickly. G2's next game is next Thursday. They currently have 363 days undefeated. It'll be up to 369 if they win this series.
Ooh.
Just shy of 400. Look at me doing that play-by-play math.
Domestic dominance.
Domestic. Yeah, but I mean, that is the narrative, isn't it? Right?
You don't have to talk about international. Yes. We'll keep it within Europe. They have looked so strong. When you take into account that this is like the top flight league in Europe, for a team to maintain this level of performance is near unprecedented.
For the first time since Fnatic.
Yeah.
All right, Fnatic won back-to-back-to-back-to-back titles.
Yeah.
And then, unfortunately, the decline has now found them in a position where they are arguably in the worst shape they've been since the LCS began. Alternatively, the new hotness in the LCS, Misfits, they have pushed G2 all the way to game three. And, you know, regardless of how this game ends, I think Misfits will be potentially kicking themselves for game number one. This is a replay of just exactly how Perks was caught out.
Yeah, this is the engage on Perks. You can see Kakao wasn't reacting in time.
We can't actually jump into that because it's Misfits that have been jumped on. Expect, he gets booted backwards. Here comes Sven. He's got the Hurricane ticking. Expect, look at all of those Ren snacks. Good, the hugest amount of damage, though.
Good defensive play out of Misfits. They didn't bring Alfari to the fight. The rest of the team called that they were disengaging. G2 may rush this down at the 20-minute mark here. Look at the Caitlyn traps coming through. They know they have TP advantage. Alfari must leave the lane.
Okay, Expect committed flash and teleport for that flank maneuver, and only got the Dragon's Rage kick from Kakao. No other summoners and no other ultimates.
Misfits would call the bluff right now and take mid tower while G2 is stalling. At this point, it's easy enough to push over, and it gives Misfits the gold gain off this play. They are still behind, but it's enough to deter G2 from pushing. They ultimately come out ahead.
All right, ultimately from that play?
Yes,
from
just
summoner
that.
Spells as well as the objectives. It's a minute and a half until the next dragon is alive. Baron was a potential play, but nobody went for it. And obviously no QSSs on anyone else other than Perks right now. Alfari and Expect, let's see how they go. Trick is coming in for support. Alfari's gonna be able to hop over the wall. Meganar will come up shortly. Buy some time, doesn't find a stun. The cocoon catches Alfari out. He's gonna get run down. Boulder Toss comes out, the little spiderlings hammering away, and one or two lost autos. Trick and Expect, I mean, it was somewhat inevitable to run him down.
Alfari shoved up too far in the jungle. The rest of his team had recalled. This is one of the problems in trying to play the side lane when the rest of your team is just backing to base, is you have no support, whereas you can easily get 2v1. We've talked about how good Elise Renekton is in the early game. Well, that's still just as good if it's 2v1 later on.
And it's not late enough for Gnar to be able to outclass everybody, right? G2 with the numbers advantage take an uncontested tower. And this is trickle down, right? Alfari pushes too far with, you know, not enough vision. He went too far. And that means G2 turn it round. They get the kill, they get the tower, and deep vision.
Look at the focus, though, out of Misfits. This is what we've seen from them week after week. The moment G2 cannot stop them getting this control around Baron, the pings went down instantly. Misfits now looking for a play around mid lane. They were just spotted on a ward. Ignore on Trick!
Flash exhaust!
He's gone!
There we go. Taken down. Flash ult, rather. Nethergrass blocks him down.
Pretty sure Ignar, or at least one of the members of Misfits, was spotted on that ward we just saw in mid lane. So Trick, not respecting the engage potential out of Misfits. They hadn't seen them on the map in quite some time.
That might set up a safe dragon here.
Oh, they've got Kalista. It absolutely will be safe.
That's the cost of that play. Not enough vision inside the river and not enough information. Unfortunately for Trick, he gets flash engaged on. It's also difficult, right? Like, he's not even really at the river just yet. He manages to get burst down, but look at the damage from Power of Evil. Only 15 CS behind now in one QE combo. Chunks out Sven.
Back and forth we go between these two teams. Game three, two Infernal Drakes on Misfits. Are those the two Drakes that turn this game back around against G2? Because while Misfits are behind, they have fast Baron, they have high AoE damage and potency in teamfights, so if G2 do make a mistake and lose 2 to 3 players, that's a Baron. This game turns right around.
Especially when you look at the amount of hard CC that can come down to the
Alfari
Misfits squad.
Pushing has TP advantage here, so it's on Misfits for if they call G2's bluff. You can see now the blue trinket goes down. It's too late to actually stop it before the Baron goes, but Misfits, they want to fight on the tail end.
Okay, G2 get Baron. Kakao kicks Perks away. Shockwave is available. Where's it going to land? Pulls three. Misfits together. G2 escape with the Baron.
Good play out of G2, taking the Baron down. They knew they could at least bring Alfari over, and Alfari had just had Meganar expire before the TP, so he was not ready to commit to a full fight. Misfits, we spoke about how fast their Baron would go down. Well, G2 had that Mountain Drake. They had good damage on it, and they knew they could beat Misfits to the punch.
Near flawless Baron play. And we talk so much about how this game mirrored game two.
Mm-hmm.
Now the Baron play mirrors game one, where G2 just have a super decisive, quick play that secures Baron because Misfits just too far away, just too slow to respond.
And now Misfits are really up against it with no TP for a flank, no real ability to step out on the side lane anymore for Alfari for a while, thanks to this Baron buff. They have to face down a Caitlyn, Lulu, Orianna composition head on.
Yeah.
That is near impossible to actually find an engage that works on Sven. And if Sven survives, they can continue to push.
That's right, two QSSs on the side of G2. Expect on himself that Titanic plus the Black Cleaver.
Look
and
where Ignar
is shoving
is.
Mid lane.
Ignar is trying to come down, but it's Expect that will block him soon. Ignar trying for any kind of flank, but G2, they have a QSS on Sven as well, so already that Malzahar is not enough.
Oh, it's just obnoxious. Caitlyn's range, plus traps, plus picks, plus whimsy. Like, there are so many tools for Sven to remain safe. And he's got himself Flash and Heal available, plus that 90 caliber net, so...
And that QSS, yeah. Everything is safe for Sven for now. It would take a monumental mechanical error from Sven, which he is not known for.
No, not at all. 002 on that Caitlyn, getting a couple of autos, Command Protect, as well as that shield from Mithy. Now Inspector's being slowly bullied away.
Ignar's waiting for Perks to come around that corner, though. Expect does get pushed back. It's enough to deter the mid lane push. And look at top. It's going to go in favor of Misfits during this push. But Sven pushes back in with the Baron minions. Power of Evil trying to push them back.
There's still over a minute before Baron times out. Teleports onto the minion. Expect's going to let this one finish. And Hansama is trying to clear out the way. The tower goes down and G2 are inside the base. It's an 8,000 gold lead. Super minions are about to get secured in the bottom lane, and Misfits just stand idly by.
Yeah, for any hope for Misfits to defend that, they needed Power of Evil. He did get dropped low, didn't die. If Power of Evil had died, that may very well have been the game right there in that moment. Misfits, damage done to the base. Inhibitor is down. That is a Gwinsu's Rage Blade on Hansama, not opting for the Hurricane, looking for that on-hit damage, which was improved from that Blade of the Ruined King setup as well. Seen Gwinsu's Rage Blade on Cogmore, but not commonly on Kalista in pro play.
No, absolutely not. It is a new patch, of course, and Gwinsu's has been changed ever so slightly. Yeah. He's going to keep increasing the attack speed as well, plus additional damage. AD rather. And of course, amplifying that damage on hit, as you mentioned, Stretch. They synergize very well with Blade of the Rune King, but it might not be enough. It might just be too late. Misfits need to find a flanking opportunity. Misfits need to find a way to get behind G2 and get onto Sven while simultaneously not being caught by a shockwave.
Yeah, that's always that big deterrent in fights. The thing about that Gwinsu's, the reason why we see it on Cogmore is Cog still benefits from AP in a lot of his kit. Kalista, not so much. really not at all.
Well, the item works,
but
right?
The theory is there, but the reason that you end up seeing people going Hurricane is because you stack up those Ren stacks again and again and again, and you mentioned it, the change that happened to Kalista. You get multiple Rens off in a fight on multiple targets. Maybe that's enough to carry it through. I want to watch Hansama, though. There must be something in this. There must be a reason. And I want to watch how his damage output changes thanks to this Gwinsu's, because very rare you see a player go for some unorthodox build and he doesn't have a reason to do it.
Yeah, that's the truth. And there's a new patch as well, just clearing out those traps as G2 shoved the wave in. They've got supers in the bottom lane. They've now got absolute map control and no teleport on Expect. So Alfari will be quite content and comfortable to deal with this bottom lane. And G2, they're just gonna set up the waves appropriately and look to close out clean.
Yeah, Alfari's gonna get stronger and stronger though, just absorbing all of those super minions, that farm in the bot lane. Oh, Ignar.
All right, let's take a look. Flash away from Ignar.
There goes an engage tool. Flash down defensively. Puts Misfits with fewer options to get a fight started.
And Stress, almost every time Ignar is trying to roam and move around, Expect seems to be dashing onto him. If you think back for the last 10 or so minutes, Expect inside this blue side jungle of Misfits has almost been face checking with Ignar, you know, trying to control some of that vision, trying to pop that passive and jump onto him. And this time around, Ignar is forced to use that summoner spell to escape.
The benefit is Misfits aren't a man down. They aren't suddenly up against it. The dragon did go over to G2. Now Ignar, no flash. He's making a mistake.
Look at that. Woo. Just completely run down. Lulu, Caitlyn, the synergy plus the itemization.
So remember 15 seconds ago when I said he gets out with his life and that's fine? That one didn't happen that time, and Baron's coming up in a minute. So that gives G2 easily the position to take everything away from this topside jungle, put wards down, push back Misfits. They still have the inhibitor down in the bottom side. And G2 going from strength to strength in this game.
What I loved about the previous Baron was just how safely G2 were able to take the inhibitor. Yes, it took the entire duration of the buff, but that's fine. You can live with that. They didn't overextend. They played at maximum range of Caitlyn and waited for Expected TP back in, etc. You know, it was very, very controlled.
And now they know that they can do that all again, because with Ignar only just coming back, G2 just got a recall available, and there's with no warding potential for Misfits over the last 30 seconds. So they know Misfits haven't got control over that Baron area. Baron is now alive. Misfits are going to try and push down mid for now.
So G2 are split up. We need to follow Kakao if he gets a good Sonic Wave. Alternatively, where's the Gnar bar? Alfari's being run down. Without Mega Gnar, G2 don't really fear
the
engage.
Buying time.
Power of Evil is chunked down. The QW combo, PoE's forced backwards. Redemption's gonna heal up Misfits, and Misfits looking to chase. Look at the minimap, super minions. They're pushing onto the Nexus Towers.
Yeah, Misfits are trying to come around. Oh, Ignar!
That's a good shockwave. Hansama actually uses the Fate's Call.
All G2 need to do is back away and buy more time. They're still pushing in, but that inhib has just respawned. So it is now a weakness for Misfits rather than their Achilles heel at this point. It is not killing them slowly, but G2 are coming through that top side, looking to try and pick anybody off. Look where Kakao already is, trying to catch a straggler. Maybe trying to stop any kind of Baron play here.
There's still a ward in the pit.
Can he?
Sweep is available.
Oh,
that's
going to
get cleared out. Teleport coming down for Alfari. I can't see his Gnar bar. We need to keep track of that. It's about to pop. Meganar's coming in. Red Team G2. They secure Baron. Alfari's in the pit. He's got support from Kakao. Where is Sven? He's running away for his life. Trick caught in the pit alone. He's going to get run down. GA is popped, and I think the spider will get squashed under Misfit's boot. It is a small, small victory for G2 to secure the Baron.
Well, it's sizable enough that G2 will be happy. Yes, they lose it on Trick. Good defense keeping Kakao away from the pit as it was going lower and lower. Alfari got a good start to this fight, but the damage wasn't quite there. Power of Evil was trying desperately to get to the fight and lock down everybody else from G2, but fast enough on the recall. Those empowered recalls as Trick was dying gets the rest of G2 out of harm's way, and they continue with a 9,000 gold lead. Here was the TP coming in from Alfari. Kakao was looking to try and get in the back, but Mithy goes right into him, gets that knockup, polymorph. Kakao had no option. Alfari hits at least three with that, but only now does the damage come in. Hansama had to jump off a trap as it was setting, but it wasn't quite enough. And you can see at the top of your screen, Sven was out of there before Trick even fell.
Yeah. Misfits a little too late to the party, unfortunately. And G2 got their cake, and they're going to eat it. Despite the damage from Alfari, it was a slightly awkward fight, you know. Damage graph doesn't necessarily tell the story, because G2 still in absolute control. 10,000 gold up, the second Baron of the game. And they're looking to go 10-0 in the spring split here in 2017.
A monumental performance. Very few teams have that kind of win-loss record. Fnatic did an undefeated split.
What feels like an eternity ago.
That was best of one days. That was not best of threes. Not to take anything away from that, but it certainly is an uphill battle when you've got to take somebody down twice.
It does indeed, and that's what Misfits seem to be unable to do. Cocoon is on cooldown now as Trick catches out one of those grabs. Some damage onto Sven, a lot of damage from Power of Evil with that Void Staff. Death Ray comes down and Sven just using Caitlyn to full advantage, sieging up. That was a very, very early Caitlyn-Orianna combination, and it is paying off for G2 Esports.
They still have Shockwave available if Misfits choose to go aggressive. You can see how Sven, utilizing that extra range rapid fire cannon, that core item on Caitlyn. Now Alfari wants to go, double jumps in. That's his Meganar proc'd. We'll be able to push the wave back, but if there's a fight, once this expires, Alfari does not have that crowd control available.
Window of opportunity here for G2. They sense it and feel it.
Flashing
rage
onto
Sven. QSS comes out. Sven's able to escape. Wild Growth still available. And Ignar also got pulled in by the Fate's Call. G2, rinse, repeat, do it again.
Yeah, trading those defensive capabilities. Sven did not have to flash, and his heal is nearly available. But that QSS is now down. If he mispositions, he can get locked down, but Sven tends not to do that.
And there's so many tools. Still got Flash and Heal and Wild Growth. Command Protect as well. Alfari's Gnar bar is about to max out. He could jump out into G2.
We're 35 minutes in, though, so Victor is the name of the game for Misfits. One Chaos Storm, a Q auto and a laser will take Sven out. You catch that combo. It's difficult to do, but at this point, we're getting to the stage where Power of Evil is enough in teamfights if it connects, but that's a lot of ifs and buts.
Yeah, it really is. It's so difficult to navigate. Navigate through a battlefield with a Victor to make that work. Sven, Mythi, and Trick, they're going to pick up the fifth dragon of the game. Mountain, Cloud, and Fire for G2. Next one will be Elder. I don't know if G2 will even need an Elder. They still maintain this gigantic 10,000 gold lead. There are still supers in the bottom lane, and there's no tower in the mid lane for Misfits to defend.
And as much as people have gone back and forth on what G2 have been practicing for, this is the moment that has been talked about. We are into the later stages of the game. Supposedly, this is what their focus has been about. And with an undefeated streak on the line, we are getting to the point where one mistake in decision making would give Misfits the window back into the game. G2 have a significant lead. They have looked dominant all game long, and they can still close this one out.
Absolutely. Look at the itemization, by the way. Double GAs on the side of Misfits with Kakao and Alfari. Trix is on cooldown from that previous Baron engage, and Expect's got a GA of his own.
Ignar.
Some tools available to them. Ignar still dancing on the edge, looking for some form of vision. Passive gets popped there by Sven's auto, and the rest of G2, look, they're just waiting to protect Sven, waiting
shield
to use every single cooldown.
The shield on Sven. Kakao, he's got in,
he's
got him!
Sven's gonna go down, not
he's still
Sven.
Alive!
Look at the lifesteal! Finally, Sven is taken out. Shockwave, that's gonna be enough. Power of Evil gets himself a double kill.
They turned it round.
Trick is running for his life. Kakao with the hero play. Kakao is looking for more. Trick's gonna go down. Golden from his hourglass, and the rest of G2 are running. Can Misfits take anything else?
No Baron for a minute, but Misfits, they can clean their base up. They will lose. Likely another inhibitor tower. No Kakao saves. Oh, not quite enough.
We absolutely need a replay of that kick. Kakao catching Sven. That is the moment that keeps Misfits' hopes alive. They are still losing. They are still behind. But this buys them crucial, crucial time.
They're going to get gold off this play. They're going to get some of that lead back. It's a tower for now. They can clean out some of the wards. But look at how many G2 wards stand in the jungle of Misfits. Expect wants to chase Power of Evil and the rest of Misfits back. They need to buy time. 30 seconds until Baron and everyone from G2 will still be alive at that point. But Misfits, they need to secure some sense of vision. G2 will quickly take down this Baron once it has spawned if Misfits cannot fight it. And look at it, there's a lot of summoners not available. Ignar's ult is nearly back up. Power of Evil has no flash. Kakao has no flash, but he does have the kick. And Alfari, TP is there. There are a handful of wards that would allow him to get into the back line. One in the mid lane. And G2 have got to play this carefully.
Yeah.
Here comes the TP. They're trying to get it to go. Meganar is nearly built up. He's nearly there.
Available. Where is Sven? Follow Sven. He uses a 90 caliber net to try to get away. Alfari, Meganar's backwards with his no stun. Sven's still alive. Expect buying as much time on the front line as he can. He'll respawn to the GA.
They got Sven!
Misfits! Can they do this? They've traded one for one. Power of Evil is down. Hans Sommer is trying to dash forward. Mythi's going to be the target. He flashes to safety. The rest of Misfits, they're running him down. Stress! Misfits, they are not giving up.
Can they close in the net here? Perk still has a lot of damage. No shockwave, but he has mana available. G2 are going to turn and run on the only safe escape route as minions stream into the building, the base of Misfits bot lane.
The inhibitor is going to be the focus for those minions. There's a smite available for Trick. Where is he on the minimap?
They've got the Callisto Rend. They can out-damage Trick here if they can deny his entry to the pit, but is it all about the damage here? Expect goes in, they've got Ignar.
It's a 4-for-4, Ignar's down. Now it's 4-for-3. Hans Sommer follows thereafter. The minions, they're on the Nexus turrets. G2 are trying to get the rest
TP's
of Misfits.
Coming through.
Alfari uses the Gnar. His GA is going to get popped. Expect, he's teleported to the Nexus. Is this the final push? G2, they lose the fight, but they bounce back. They kill Misfits, and now expect he's on the Nexus turret.
Power of Evil will save the Nexus towers with Kakao, or at least the Nexus. It's not going to be enough to save the towers, but G2 go for the Baron, and when it looked like everything was lost, G2 maintain control.
Expect with the sass. Stands toe-to-toe with Kakao, throws down the laugh, and G2, despite potentially throwing this game away, they find a way back in, and it's thanks to this team fight.
Yeah, Trick comes aggressive here. They're just deterring the Baron attempt. Misfits maybe a little over-eager here, did not realize how Expect could get his way into the back of the fight. Perks, it didn't even matter that he missed the shockwave, as it was enough with the rest of the team to take down Alfari, get Expect into the base, take both Nexus towers, and now it should be a clinical walk down mid lane.
It should have been.
It should be.
It should
as
have
well.
Been a few minutes ago. But Sven being caught out, he's got no flash available. Will be soon.
One more shot. Ignar has flash. Hansam is not with the team. Neither is Sven. G2 are not ready to push yet. No. Misfits aren't ready to defend yet, but they have to ace G2 and defend their base if they want to win this best of three. But this is the closest, arguably, that G2 have come to dropping this undefeated streak.
Misfits, they're still 10.
They're
13,
so far ahead.
They're 13,000 gold ahead, Stress. It's still a gigantic lead. Yes, those team fights were mistakes. There's no doubt about that. But G2 would need to do more of those mistakes.
Look at Trick. Trick wanted to walk those minions in. Baroned up. This should be an easy push for the win out of G2. Three lanes if they want it with supers and Baron minions.
Take a look at that. 9 wins and 1 loss when teams have a 10,000 gold lead or more. The only shameful loss there was the Unicorns of Love. Unable to close out. G2, will they make it 10-1?
Oh,
will they remain 10-0?
They're going for the base.
The hourglass, the rest of G2, they're looking for Power of Evil. Perks gets shut down. That's the first kill for Misfits. It's going to be traded back. Ignore looks to be run down by
Hansama.
They traded one for one. With no Hansama, with no more frontline, there's no more damage for Misfits. G2 get a double kill. Sven is sent into the fountain, but the tower goes down, and G2 remain undefeated in Europe. It was so dramatic at the end. But the lead was too insurmountable for Misfits. Despite the teamfight victories and the mistakes from G2.
That Baron call out of Misfits, they turn for it, get punished. But think of how close they're taking it. G2 with a massive lead throughout the game. Right up to that late game, the last few team fights. But as soon as that last Baron goes down, they just walk it in. Enough of a lead, they just walk in, push the Nexus.
Baron empowered minions, let the minions do the work. Let them focus down the Misfits members. And G2, you saw the flash up there, 393 days. That'll be extended to 399. Hanging out with the CSGO squad. With a team owner as well. No pressure, guys. Had to show up there. But G2 came through in the end. I mean, look, we don't want to oversell, right? They had a 10,000 gold lead for what felt like 15 to 20 minutes of the game.
But that wasn't... A lot of people say, oh, you know, it's not exciting when there's a 10,000 gold lead. You tell me that Misfits weren't fighting back. That fight where Kakao finds Sven, that's how 10,000 gold leads get lost.
Yes.
But it was G2 regathering control after
and
that.
What a kick from Kakao. I mean, that was just a highlight reel worthy. So unfortunate they lost the game. But but I'm going to go back to game number one. And I feel like Misfits, they were slow to start. When you see how proactive they were in games two and three, how exciting their play style was, they've got to find that gear earlier.
Yeah, I completely agree. I love this is a really entertaining series.
Yes.
In the sense that I'm glad Misfits showed up in game two, actually showed us some fights in game three. It's still clear G2 are so difficult to even take a game off at times.
10-0, undefeated. That basically makes their first place seed going into the semifinals very, very safe. They have a three-game series deficit between first and second. So, you know, they're looking very comfortable and, again, remaining the kings of Europe, Stress.
Yeah, remaining on top. G2 dominant, Misfits on their heels at times. Yeah. Looking forward to playoffs.
Yeah, Misfits, they lost to H2K last week. They lost to G2 this week. They've got to scramble to get themselves together before playoffs. But for more on exactly how G2 won that game, let's talk to Dracos and Sven.
Thank you very much, Quinn.